Hello and welcome to the Belgian city of Antwerp for the World Gymnastics Championships. Now 410 gymnasts have travelled here from 76 nations to get their hands on just 12 titles, and it's set to be a star-studded affair with no less than 7 of the Olympic champions from London 2012 chalked up and ready to go. So, a glittering cast, and after qualification, Great Britain are hopeful with 9 finalists. Quite an achievement when you consider that the team doesn't include 2 of Britain's greatest ever gymnasts.
Well, Lewis, now is the time. What does this Olympic final have in store for Beth Tweddle?
Come on, Lewis, keep your head.
She must focus now.
This is going extremely well.
Straight to the low bar, straight to the high bar.
That is superb!
It's... oh! Big step back, but she saved it.
Lewis Smith settles for silver.
Beth Tweddle takes the bronze.
Well, they may not be competing, but I'm delighted to say that they are part of our coverage. So hello to Britain's most decorated gymnast, Beth Tweddle, and World and Olympic medalist, Lewis Smith. Now, Beth, you announced your retirement, didn't you? It was on the anniversary of winning that bronze medal. Was that always planned?
It wasn't planned, no. I mean, it just took me that long to kind of make that decision. It was 20 years of my life. You don't kind of just wake up one day and decide that's it. And I think everyone knew around me. Amanda knew as soon as I presented at the Olympics that was me done. But
for me, I just couldn't let go.
And even now, I'm still in the gym 3-4 times a week.
And even, I mean, the governing body of World Gymnastics, they've given you a role. Everybody wants a piece of you, Beth.
Yeah, I've just been voted in as athlete representative for the women's, so it's just kind of been the voice of the gymnasts, and obviously it keeps my hand in at top-level gymnastics.
Yeah. Now, Lewis, obviously the anniversary of your medal has passed, and you didn't announce your retirement.
No announcements yet. No.
Come on, then, what's happening?
Still clinging on, you know. I mean, I thought it would be nice to have a sit and laid-back approach, but I've come here and I've got itchy feet. I still feel like I've got some fuel in the tank.
Is that really?
I've always got fuel in the tank, you know. Even when I'm 30, I still jump on the pommel horse. But I could still get down there and mingle with them.
Good. Well, this competition, it's all about the individuals. There's no competition, team competition, I should say, this year. So we're going to be focusing on the men's all-around that happened yesterday. And then this evening, you can see live coverage of the women's all-around final with Great Britain's Becky Tunney and Ruby Harold as well. And then on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, we've got the individual apparatus finals. So going on floor for Great Britain, Daniel Purvis, Max Whitlock. We go on the pommel horse there, hoping for a world medal here. And uneven bars, got Becky Downey and Ruby Harrell going on Saturday as well. And then Sunday, Christian Thomas will be vaulting for Great Britain. So, I mean, as we said at the top there, I mean, 9 finalists, very successful in qualification. Would you expected more, Lewis, from the men's side?
I mean, this World Championship has been an individual first year after 2012. Mm-hmm. It is the hardest World Championship. So, I mean, it's that every country is invited. So it is that the hardest World Championships to make a final. So I think we've done well so far. We could have had Daniel Keatons on pommels and Christian on the high bar.
Yeah, well, this is the thing. I mean, have you spoken to Dan since? Because he had a nightmare, didn't he, in qualification? Obviously really hoping for a place in the pommel final.
I mean, well, he's the reigning European champion. So he came into this competition, you know, wanting to make a world final. And, you know, unfortunately had a very uncharacteristic mistake and, you know, he was off.
Did you think he was going a little bit too tentatively? Because he normally swings a little bit faster, doesn't he?
I mean, I think he felt comfortable. You know, he started his routine, it was all going really well, and his shoulders just got away from him on that wee travel. And all it takes is that split second, and it can all change.
How about on the women's side, Beth?
On the women's side, I think we kind of lived up to the expectation. We were hoping for Rebecca and Ruby to be in the all-around, and then we always knew there was a chance of two bar finals, but we would have been definitely happy with one. So the fact that we've got them both in there is really good.
It is a remarkable achievement when you think that since the World Championships began, there's only five different gymnasts that have actually medalled. Two of them, well, you sat here. So to see this many great British gymnasts in the finals, I mean, it does say an enormous amount for what's happening in the gyms.
And the fact that me and Beth can take a back seat and see almost two people making our finals.
Yeah.
Because Daniel and Max could have made pommels. Yeah. And we've got two in the uneven bars. So it's nice to see that we've actually given GB guys a chance to, fulfil our roles.
Yeah, well, Ollie Williams caught up with both Dan and Max just after qualification to see how they're feeling ahead of the men's all-around final.
Yeah, I had a few silly mistakes in there, but overall I'm happy with that competition. It was a good experience for me to get out there, and I'm very happy to have made the finals I've made.
In the end, it was really good. Because starting on high bar, my first piece was a bit of a disaster, really, unexpected one. I put my hands down and went this way, and the rest of the routine was a bit scruffy, but then it seemed to go smoothly and ended up in the all-round final, so no, it worked out really well.
There's a lot of strong competitors out there, but you know, I just want to go out there and hopefully have a clean competition, and if I do that I'll be happy, and hopefully go out there, stay chilled and enjoy it, and hopefully show some good routines.
The team was so hard to get in this year. The all-round, between me and Sam was very difficult because he's a great all-rounder as well, so I did want to come here and justify that I've got the all-round spot, and yeah, I was very happy with the way it turned out, and even with my high bar down I could still finish in top eight, which is a big confidence boost, and I know if I do what I did in training, then I'll be up there. So, yeah, I just want to enjoy it and, you know, just stay calm under pressure.
There's a lot of strong competitors out there and, hopefully I can go out there and show that, try and prove that I'm hopefully one of the top ones.
Well, there's only 2 years between them in age, but I mean, they're at very different stages in their career, aren't they? I mean, Dan, he's been through it all. He's been, World, Olympic, all sorts. He's had an enormous amount of experience, so he can afford to sit back and look at this. But for Max, I mean, this is his first goal, really, all round, isn't it, on all six pieces, Lewis?
It is. I mean, he's done fantastically well to deal with that pressure, the expectation after 2012.
Yeah.
And to really, stamp his claim as one of the best, all-arounders that we've got at the minute. And he seems to be doing a good job.
Yeah, and a quick word then on the all-around gymnast, Beth, because you obviously competed on all pieces and then you start to specialise. Yeah. It's a very different discipline, isn't it?
It's totally different. I mean, when you're just doing that one piece, you've just got to psych yourself up for sort of 30 seconds. But when you're doing that all-around competition, it can be two and a half hours that you've got to keep on top of yourself. If you make that small mistake, you've got to build yourself back up and get back on with it.
But even in your training, I mean, obviously, you're doing more pieces, aren't you? So you've got to break it up more.
It is. I mean, you can't just spend all the hours on one piece. You've got to spend the hours making sure that every apparatus is top-notch. I mean, you do tend to find that every all-arounder will have their specialist pieces and they have that one piece that is always their downfall.
Yeah, OK, well, there'll be 24 gymnasts going in this final, so let's have a look at how that breaks up. So the top group, or the top six from qualification, they'll be starting on floor. Now, there's two gymnasts from each country allowed in the competition, so the both Chinese gymnasts you can see there. Kohai Uchimura, I mean, goodness me, three world champions under his belt. It's a remarkable achievement. He's going in that group as well. If we move on to the next piece of apparatus, you can see those starting on pommel horse, Max Whitlock. That'll be his strongest piece. Obviously, Dan Purvis hoping for a really good start as well. Hamboushan's in there. He got a silver at the World Championships back in 2007. We'll move on to rings. Let's see who's starting on there. So, well, Verneyev will be interesting. He got a bronze at the European Championships. Malievsky's in there as well, current Russian champion. And Vault, the final four groups there, they'll be looking for an explosive start to their six pieces of apparatus. So who are you looking forward to seeing out of this lot?
Do you know what? Everyone's watching Uchimura. It's kind of like the gold medal is taken and everyone's fighting for silver and bronze. But who knows what?
Well, this is the thing. I mean, Uchimura, just to put it into perspective, it is quite remarkable. Svetlana Korkina, well, she was a gymnast who got three world championship all-around titles under her belt. Uchimura has managed to match that. But the question is, coming here to Antwerp, could he go one better and become the most successful gymnast of all time?
Kohai Uchimura. Uchimura wraps up. Listen to the reaction of the crowd when they hear his name. We are looking at the finest all-around gymnast that there's ever been.
Zhu Xinhong from China, 20 years old, and he qualified in fifth place.
Beautiful style, but an expensive couple of little steps there, and a red flag as well. Very confident forward tumbling, links the twisting elements very precisely. But he's hopping around a little bit. This floor is very bouncy. Many of the gymnasts have found it difficult to control landings. Oh, and he jumped. Did he put his fingers out? I think he probably did. You saw the line judge lift his red flag, so he's just been out twice. That's better. Calming down a little bit now. Oh, a little bit floppy around the feet and hesitant on the handstand. Super twist to finish. Lovely style, but a little sense of nerves, I think, Mitch.
Well, it is a world final. First up, you're going to be not completely set. And there were signs of nerves here. The technique is very secure. It's unusual. There's the kick out look in the 1 3/4 roll. Very nicely done. Score for Xishong Zhu, 14.833. Max Whitlock for Great Britain on pommels. His first event in this all-round final. Very nice in the sea shear. Calm, measured, and the one-handle combinations. Good style, smooth swing so far. Into the handstand, he'll undercut. There it is, that's good, nicely controlled. Oh, and a little bit piked on the spindle. He did well to control that. And then settled down. No problems with Zavado. G and triple Russian going well. Up he'll go. A handstand moment, and he's through very nicely indeed. Well done, Max Whitlock. A great start.
Wow, great start for Max. He'll be very happy with that.
Oleg Vanayev, Ukraine, had a torrid time qualifying. Nice combination from Ortiz, gently into cross. In the judges meeting, they did insist that these strength parts are held. And just to be safe, a good 2 seconds. His shoulders are high there. He's not in tip-top condition, Vanayev. This is the man who got the bronze all round in the Europeans. A bit short on the planche, good control on the swing down stands. Full twist double. Still, though, there are signs, Lewis, that he's not completely on his game.
I mean, rings is one of those pieces. You're either feeling great on the day or you're always a little bit undercut. It's a very difficult piece to get right.
14.733 of Vanayev. I've come here. This is Sam Mikulak, who is their great hope, really. He's a 90-plus gymnast. Didn't make it in qualifying, but let's have a look here. Opening on floor.
Oh, super opening there. 1.5 twist, immediate double front. Fabulous landing. He really looks focused, stylish. Whoa. Qualified second, and he's doing himself no harm here at all. Good control on the handstand. And the pirouette. Has to control these big tumbles. Beautiful style, rolls out smoothly. Now, he hasn't faltered. Big final tumble, triple twist, a merest hop. That, he really did not give much away there, Mitch, at all.
Well, he's one of the few gymnasts to get into the 15s on this apparatus in qualifying, and there's no sign here of nerves. If anything, he stepped up the game. That's superb. One and a half twist, one and three quarter with a kick out.
I mean, he really did show, you know, how landings are supposed to be controlled. You know, he didn't really give much away on his landing, so it was a great return.
Lovely smile from Sam Mikulic. And they really have great hopes for him. Mats Whitlock opens with a beautiful score, 15.633.
It's a great start for him. Great score in the bag for Max.
A real character. They've got great hopes for him. 21 years old.
Yeah, I can go for long.
25 in second, and it's hot out there. He's a 90-plus gymnast. We only have one in the 90s in qualifying. You don't need me to tell you who it was, but look at that start. 15.366 on an apparatus. They've been really severe. World champion, silver in 2008 Olympics, gold in London, Kohei Uchimura takes to the floor.
Au sol, Ishimura Koi pour le Japon.
Oh, 1.5 into 2.5 twist, beautifully done. He just makes it look so easy. Rolls around. Little hop back. You don't usually see that from Uchimura. So clean. 2.5, 1.5. He makes it look so easy. Everything is anticipated. He kicks it out, spots the floor. Lovely line. Fedichenko. One thing you always hear the Japanese coaches shout translates into toe point, and that's what that is. He points his toes at every opportunity. The consummate performer. Triple twist, thank you very much indeed. That was a real mark of a man in control.
Well, his opening piece just a little bit rushed on the first two tumbles, but once he got those over, the rest was fabulous. He finished his moves right out the top. Look at the time he gave himself between those tumbles. Not a flicker.
I mean, that tumble we just saw on the replay was technically perfect. I mean, he opened out, great timing, punched into the 1.5 twist, spot the, I mean, it was beautiful, beautiful work.
Fabian Mambushin. And really, this was the apparatus that let him down in qualifying.
And a great tumbler and vaulter who's never looked very at home on pommels. But if he can hold firm here and swing with style as he is at the moment, then he is going to be a serious contender for the top, not the top spot, but in the mix. And he's doing well, a little bit piked the body you can see here. Oh, and just wrestled to the finish.
Come on, Lewis, what about
that? That dismounter's on the edge, isn't it? I mean, Fabian's always struggled with pommel horse. It is a difficult apparatus to get right. And he's had a good long career. But you can always see that his pommel horse is always a bit skewed, a bit piked. And that's going to really, you know, give him some heavy deductions on that.
Skewing, the art of not keeping your hands together. You get your hands apart and it's called skewing. He really was pleased to get to that part.
Yeah, I mean, at his type of pommels, I think just going clean is a thumbs up. So he did well.
13-3-3-3. The judges doing their job because they're not fooled. You'd have to stay on, but you've got to stay on the start. Look at Uchimura, 15.558. He kicks off. He's on his way. Sergio Sasaki Jr., one of the great, talented Brazilians.
Oh, and that was a lovely, leisurely tumble, wasn't it? As we were saying, these gymnasts give themselves so much time. Another 1.5 into double front. You have to land the first tumble so precisely. Oh, and he just was a little bit short on that double twisting double back. Super control, lifts through the hands. Oh, and again, you saw how he finished the 2.5 with such ease that he could punch into the next tumble. What we got next? And the 1.5 into 1.75, they're allowed one rollout like that during the routine. Half in, double front, half out. Couple of little errors, but a good start.
21 years old, 10th he was in the London Olympics. For Brazil are coming into the spotlight.
I mean, perfect timing too. You know, I felt like he rushed through the routine a little bit. You know, the buzzer went at the end. He said I had about 4 seconds left, so he could have took a few more seconds. But quite surprising to see the talent coming through in Brazil right now.
Prepare for the next rotation.
Look at David Baliaski of rings. And this was one of his problems in qualifying. A little bit shaky on the strength positions, but that's a good start. Nice clean body line. I don't like that arch, and the shoulders are very high in the inverted. Better in the regular cross. But, again, just not in tip-top shape. The Yamawaki combination to Jonasson. Settles in cross. Just the inverted cross is the problem so far, but again, that very hollow shape leads to an inconsistent handstand. Get those rings turned out, young man. Over the top for the full twist, double straight. That's a better performance from him than qualifying. 14.533 for David Baliavsky. Dan Purvis on pommels. This is performance in the first rotation.
I think he's showing great control. He's always struggled a bit with the Wu travel. Just hit. Oh, let's see. I think for Daniel, I think just getting through the routine, I think he'll be happy with. So hopefully, getting to the end.
...14.333 for Purvis, and here's confirmation that Max Whitlock got the highest score in that first rotation, ahead of Uchimura. Ryohei Kato from Japan in third, the Kulak, Sasaki Jr. and Nikovitsky in the sixth place. Dan Purvis in 15th with 14.333. Max Whitlock umrings. Now, if he's got a piece that he's not spectacular on, it's this. He needs a steady routine here. He had problems in qualifying.
Well, fights well and makes that first hold. The static positions have to be held. Swings up to the handstand, locks it out nicely. Into the front somersault combination and up to the strength hold. Needs all his focus and concentration, lifts into handstand, controls the rings, full twisting, double straight back somersault. He looks relieved, Mitch.
Well, it's always nice, isn't it, Lewis, to stick a dismount? And that's the last impression for the judges.
I mean, he did a good routine. I mean, when you're as small as Max and you can't do all the strength holds, it's important that when you do the swing elements, they are really nice. And, you know, he's swinging through the Yamawakis here. Really nice, great control. Level top planche. I think he'll be very happy with that routine.
Here is Ryohei Kato
from Japan. Ryohei Kato, one of the youngsters that, and the thing about the Japanese, they train so in such a relaxed way, but they're focused when it comes to competition. Ryohei Kato from Japan. On the horse.
Starts with the cut in. Sheer handstand. Russian circles to the end. It's got such a good line. Good poles. Spindle on the end, a little bit skewed. Into the Shivado travel, into the Wu travel. See, he's starting to tire in a little bit, his circles are piking. He gets the dismount done.
And that's it, Lewis, he gets the dismount done. Kato goes through, swings very efficiently, not the most extended we've seen. But it's about consistency. A little tiny bit piked on that spindle. I mean, it's such a difficult move.
He started off so well, and then you could really see him start to tire. It was quite interesting. But yeah, dismount was done.
Yeah, he's relieved. Look at that. .14266. He'll be pleased with that. So it's consistency now. .14.6 for Kato, 15.5, 14.6. That's medal winning stuff if he can keep it up.
He's posting some good scores.
Sam Mikulak. Oh yeah, travel right across in sheer, not easy stuff, Lewis.
It's very hard actually to try and get yourself to one end of the pommel to the other. It's tough stuff. He's picked up nicely.
This was where he had problems in qualifying. It was the only one in the low 14s for him. What do you think? How's it going?
I mean, he's doing great. He's had no major form breaks. He's doing swinging well. He's got the Magyar Shibaido travel. Into the dismount. It's a great routine. Really a great routine.
Well, I think the Americans might say he is cooking. And it feels good. Great to have pommels out of the way. That is so impressive.
I think Sheer we just heard him say. I think we just heard him say. I'm glad we got that out of the way.
Yeah, I think you know. However advanced the swinging gets on pommels, everyone's glad to get it behind them. You know what?
It's such a stressful piece. Everyone's relief after they've done a clean pommels routine.
David Belyaski, here he is on vault.
Just one vault today, has to make it there. Oh, and he fought very hard, but those three steps back will be costly. Not as costly as sitting down, however.
14.9. Nicolas score 14.608. He's upped his game and he's like the cat with the cream. I was saying, Lewis, that Uchimura on poles, he's got a peculiar style. It's so laid back.
I mean, yeah, I mean, this is a big routine for him. Pommel horse is one of those hit or miss pieces. And I think for his case, he needs to go through.
Kohei Uchimura approaches pommel horse after a superb start to this competition.
He's got the cuts in. The reverse shear to handstand. Great style, as always. Stoppy circle on one handle. Into the rush into the end. Wu travel, great form, great style. Again, traveling, great difficulty. The Magyar travel, into the Shivado travel. No form breaks. Handstand dismount. There you go, yeah. Job done.
Well, next piece. That is superb, and he's got, we talk about his style, it's so measured, it's not hurried, it's not slow, it's such a balanced style he has on points.
And never seems to tire, does it?
Fabian Hambusch, having survived his pommel routine, approaches range, he's very, very strong, his father Wolfgang. So, Fabian Hambusch. Second piece of athletics.
When we first saw him in the Athens Olympics, he was just a young teenager, and this was a piece he struggled with, but he's become stronger and stronger, and now really enjoys rings, lifts to that lovely straight position. Shoulders could be just a fraction lower and in line with the rings. You can see how strong he's become. Beautiful body line in the handstand. Lovely lift. Straight up and kills that handstand at the top. Super double pike front with half out. Really nice work from Fabian.
Well, you heard Lewis then go, wow.
I mean, you can tell he is a professional. We talked about him competing in Athens. You know, two Olympic cycles ago, and he showed his professionalism on the rings. Great control.
And he's such a lovely guy, out of the competition arena, in the competition arena, and shoulders way high there. He'll get a big deduction, 3/10 at least, possibly 5. But that is a cracking dismount.
It feels so good to stick a dismount at the end of a routine. I can't explain.
15.133, second piece for Kohei Uchimura. 14.8, so he'll build slowly. Andrei Likovitsky for Belarus. 27 years old now. 16th he was in the Tokyo World Championships. Again, a little bit high in the inverted cross. And that giant has to settle in the cross, and it didn't. He didn't hold it. It will be expensive. And that settles nicely into straddle lever. It needs to settle down. Needs to get a clear strength part. The Giants are secure. Double pike. A little bit iffy on the strength there. Need to hold those positions. Xizhong Zhu. Pommels for China. Zhu, 20 years old, being tested in the world arena in preparation for the next cycle. Xizhong Zhu, 20 years old.
knees.
Reverse shear to handstand. A lot of gymnasts doing that now. And the normal shear to handstand. Both D values. Oh, lost a little bit of form there on the one-handed Russian. And again on the spindle. Big deductions there for bending of the legs. Really starting to look a bit scrappy in the pommel routine at the minute. A good Magyar travel. A good Shvado travel. Oh, came to crops on that Dismo. I mean, we could see, couldn't we? He was struggling.
Ran out of steam. And at this level, it can happen. When you see it, it's a surprise, but it can happen.
And he finishes off.
Have to make sure of the dismount, otherwise you minimise the damage and the score can be really low. He got on just to make sure he satisfied the code requirements. Nikovitsky, 14.166. Oleg Vanayev on vault. This is one he made earlier. And it was very, very impressive. Huge approach. Double front half, a dragon rescue. No problem. Great vaulting. 15.166 was his reward. Situation after two, Uchimura is where he likes to be, in front of his teammate Ryue Kato. Sam Mikulak has moved up to third. Mats Wicklund still on the pace in fourth equal position. Good start for young Schmidt from the Netherlands in 13th. Daniel Purvis still in 15th. Ryue Kato from Japan in second place coming into this behind the great Uchimura. And what depth the Japanese have. Very light of frame, this team, and they believe in developing strength, weight ratio. Not the bulk you expect to see, but he will be accurate and he will be strong. That's his own move. Cross in the V position. Mike Kuzogi, Takuzogi, not for the faint-hearted. Settles well in the L position. There's Jonasson, so he's done double backwards twice, double forwards twice, and that's a really good cross. Very good work from Kato here. So got a handstand, a wind up for the dismount. Double double with a big pace back, but that will do him no harm at all. He'll begin to climb back now. Two low pieces. Fabian Hambuschen, third apparatus. Now his battle will begin. His challenge starts here.
And 5.6 his start value. If it's perfect, it can score 15.6. Round off in front of the board. Lovely lift. Not quite perfect. A hop forwards, but very good and very flighty.
Well done, Hambuschen. Fabian. Plenty of attack, always a feature of gymnastics. Wraps in nice and tight, but still energy left. Fuel in the tank means an extra pace at the end. You've got to use it all up in flight.
And just a tiny bit offline. You can see he's just to the side of the white line, so the judges will deduct a bit for that.
And the atmosphere really building. Gymnastics all over this arena. Four pieces working at once. Kato score on rings. Very good indeed. 14-6-6-6 for a man who's not the strongest in the world. Sam Nikulak. In third place he was going into this rotation. Now, Lewis, you've done a bit of rings in your time. It's been a while now, then. Let's talk us through this.
He's got the back up to Maltese. It's important to keep it, you know, level and flat. The kip to Maltese, coming in from a different entry. A back up to straight top planche. A very difficult skill. I actually did that. Pike to Yamawaki, up to handstand, straight arms, it's very important. Tuck to Yamawaki, into the straddle lever. Another straddle planche. A little bit wobbly in the handstand, get some deductions there. Big double-double dismount, great landing. And another smile.
Consistency is unusual for Nikulak. They said if he hits, it'll be impressive. 14.9 for Fabian Ambush. About Nikulak, they said if he could get consistent, he's a real threat. He has scored 90 plus. He can threaten.
Oh, yeah, he's a young talent, you know, he's 20 years old. I don't think he's 20 years old, but you know, he shows great talent.
David Valiaski on parallel bars. And beautiful technician when he's on. So I hope we can see him in a good light, because every young gymnast, every coach could learn so much from his style. That's not the best of outings so far. These little rehearsals, very important at this stage.
Yes, some of the gymnasts at this stage, while they're waiting, visualise themselves performing. Was that something you did, Lewis?
It is. If you're being kept waiting like he is, I tend to just think about normal stuff like, what's my mum cooking, or just try and, you know, get away from the kind of environment of things, and then when it comes down to it, just get yourself in the zone.
That was an insight there. Top pressure and you think of your mum. That's really good.
Oh, mum's cooking. She always doesn't make a choice of eyes, isn't it?
Kohai Uchimura to rings. 51 kilos. It's about strength weight ratio.
I was going to say that, Mitch. Many good ring workers are very, very broad, full of muscles. Now, Uchimura's a very slight gymnast, but his timing is immaculate, as you could see there. And of course, the lighter you are, the less bulky you need to be. Look at that shoulder line, in absolutely level with the hands. And he swings immaculately. So measured, so controlled in all the swing phases. Legs locked together, doesn't give anything away, kills the swing, lifts the head. So he waits, and then every muscle fires together for the next move, up and in, and kills it again at the top of the handstand. Such a stylish gymnast, so full of control, double twisting, double back with a kick out. Fabulous.
He is amazing, and he's the scruffiest guy training in the gym you could wish to see. He looks like he comes in pyjamas.
Well, his hair looks like he's just woken up,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Yeah, that's yeah. But, or he's put his finger in an electric plug socket, one of the two.
But you don't have to be an expert at gymnastics to see he's world-class level. You know, he makes it look easy.
Beautiful technique. Superb. And the Ullis in the double pike. Then the double tuck, Yamawaki. It's incredible work. And watch this. Chris was so impressed. Head is down. Head is up. And then the double-double. Forgive him that little skip to the side. Amazing composure. Good luck. 14.775 on rings. Chimura, 15.1. Look at that string of 15s. 45.791 at halfway translates into a score over 91. Sergio Sasaki Jr. from Brazil. Real powerhouse, this guy. Up Rise Maltese. That inverted hang is so important. That's where they get the composure and the beat for the next skill. Very, very important position. It looks so easy, but you need to time it right. That's nice. The upstart hook kick into Maltese with such control. Five double tuck and nails the punch. A little bit of skew there. Straighten it up. Double double with a pace just to set himself down. But what a future this young man has got. 21 years old, part of the Brazilian surge towards world level.
Well, they're building for Rio very much. And if they keep improving at this rate, they're going to be a force in men's gymnastics. I've really been impressed with the increasing difficulty of the dismounts off rings this championships.
Sergio Sasaki, 14.6. Just dropped a little on pommel horse, but a good series so far. Building nicely. Andrei Nikovitsky
wraps in. We're seeing the slow motion of the double twist. But that's expensive, the step to the side.
It was indeed, 14.133. Max Whitlock on vault.
Important piece here for Max. Big two and a half twist, a hop forwards, but that was well controlled.
Good score, 14.733. Oleg Manaev. Third all-round in the European Championships. One of the great hopes for Ukraine gymnastics. That's a lovely start. Hommer, pure swing to handstand. And a somersault half turn. Nice scoop technique. To one rail. And the heely out of it. This is nice work from Banayev. Tip out. Just a little hesitation there. Oh, and he's bashed the bars on the Vapsar. So that will be expensive. Little dip of body shape at the top. Settles in the studs. Here's the double pike. He did well to keep that going.
He did. I think he got the hardest bit out of the way. And he started to relax a little bit. Wake him up a bit, I think, when he kicked that wooden parallel bar. It's going to be sore in the morning.
He's got a very nice rhythm and style here, hasn't he? He's one of those gymnasts that make everything look very easy.
I mean, he's got a beautifully put together P-bar routine. It goes from element to element. Great difficulty. It's really good.
beautiful basic work, but that was the expensive and painful error.
Ouch.
Have a nice graze there. Hope he's bought some pseudocrim.
Kevin Purvis on the runway for Great Britain. Big vault for him at this stage. 2.5 twists, and he fought to hold that landing. A rare 15.033, and they're hard to come by in this competition, a 15. Well done, Dan Purvis. And I have 15 on parallel bars, and remember, that's with a contact on the apparatus. So that could have been high 15s. Brilliant stuff from the man. Uchimura increasing his lead, almost a mark clear of Banayev, who's moved up into second. Kato, the other Japanese, into third. Sam Mikulak still at the races, and so is Max Whitlock there, just a shade behind. Fabim Hambushin, 13th. Strange to see him there. Sam Mikulak from the USA. Was there in fourth place coming into this rotation. Here he is with Bolt.
Just one chance. Has to make it work. He does. A little bit untidy in the legs, but no problem with the landing or the direction. As the coach says, right down the line.
I mean, the great thing about the American gymnasts is their enthusiasm grows through the competitions, so they're going to be getting hyper and more excited as it goes on. Great vault.
Well, actually, he hopped back in the line, didn't he? He didn't land it on the line. He very cleverly hopped back to the line.
David Balyaski. Hi, Bart. Well, never make a prediction about high bar. It's a tough one to go through. Oh, and there you go. As I speak, he finds himself with a very early dismount. So, problems then for David Balyaski. Look at the focus in that man. Uchimura. Koei Uchimura for Japan. Almost a point ahead after three. Here he is with number four. That stance. He is so relaxed, so measured.
And six star value, so it's a big vault coming up. Oh, 2.5 twist off the handspring. Beautiful flight, beautiful style, quite a deep landing by his standards.
Yeah, he had to pike into a little bit and then pike down quite a lot to get the landing.
Huge push, huge determination, but the arms weren't quite straight, so he wouldn't have got the height he wanted. And there's the result.
And this is probably the piece of apparatus where his real slight physique shows the most. You know, the vault is the same height for everybody, and if you're small, it's a long way up and over.
Good luck. 14.833, the vault. Good steady stuff from him. Sekio Sasaki. Look at the power. Bustles along. Dragulescu, the half turn in the double front. You could see the bustling, charging approach. He wasn't going to miss it. He was having a good competition.
Yeah, another highly tariffed vault. Good style. Tucks really neatly and tidily. Times the turn very well indeed.
And what's interesting, he could get even higher if he didn't bend his legs so early.
Yeah, that's a good point.
He has great potential.
Noshin can't write him off. He's down in 13th, but he's got three very strong apparatus. Fabian Hambuschen. Half turn, but he was short. Might not get the value. And then under somersault. Little bit loose. Now he's recovered well in the full turn. Slightly askew on the Pilicic. Good kick out from the double. Settling down now, Fabian. Oh, that's lovely. The way he just closed and accelerated into the double fight. Little skip back. Now, yes, 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 he said. Now I'm on target.
I mean, it's good to see him getting back into the swing.
And that was a really neatly packed routine. One difficulty after the other. And as you said, you could see his confidence gaining once the tricky bits were over. Very controlled, lovely Titan lift off the parallel bars.
Uchimura 15.333. Look at that string of scores. Andrei Ludovitsky, Belarus. Nice half turn, briskly into the giant. Good straight arms in the peach. Nice line in the handstand. Clean in the heely, that time to upper arms. Through the shoulders, nicely setting up. This is nice swinging, good basics. And a pace back on the double pike. Clean. Quietly impressive.
It was a great routine. Started very promising and went through the routine. So, yeah, I'll be happy with that.
Very stylish gymnast. Typical of all the gymnasts from Belarus over the years. Beautiful technique.
Ryohei Kato had himself pushed down into third at halfway after second place, but he's got lots still to offer. Very young man, very promising.
Has to be dynamic here, and he is. Now that's one of the best double twists, 2.5 twisting vaults we've seen.
20 years old, the future mapped out, part of the Japanese super machine.
Yeah, it was it was great. Great landing, opened out. Didn't look for the floor, so his momentum didn't carry forward too much. As you can see here, opens up. Great roll.
So Kato's score, 14.8 on vault. Sergio Sasaki on vault scored 15.2. Fabian Hambuschen, the long road back, 15.233, with two very strong apparatus still to come. Andrei Lukovitsky, 15.058 on parallel bars. Matt Whitlock. And he's had a good, steady competition. Gone with the nerves that were fluttering around in qualifying. So Max Whitlock for Great Britain, parallel bars, fourth apparatus.
Swings to handstand. Here comes the big front summy. Nice straight handstand position. Healy turn, working smoothly onto the one rail. Lifts clear of the bar. controls that well. Up, big dismount, just a slight hop back. He'll be very happy to have that routine performed the way he has.
I mean, he was good at thinking on his feet there, because he made a slight error, had to bail out with the upstart, and he couldn't do it again somewhere else. So he really thought quick on his feet.
Oleg Vernayev on high bar. Now, if I can tell you this, Chris, he's a brilliant gymnast. He scored 11 in qualifying. Everything that could have gone wrong did go wrong. Let's see whether he's got next competition mentality. That's a very good start. Here's where the nightmare began. Let's put the extra swing in before the release. That's more likely. He was off in qualifying. Now he's settling down. Oh, and he's broken again. Focus. And again. The nightmare is revisited. Oh, and he's lost focus completely. Yep, what can you do?
Now, that is a prime example of a gymnast not thinking quickly on his feet. Rather give up and just hop off.
I mean, he's caught himself out. You know, he really should have, like you said, tried to think as quick as possible, plan, you know, for something going wrong, and he really hasn't. And a simple mistake there. I mean, he's just come down off a simple long swing.
Vernayev is well off his game, and that was short. He had a full twist. But now let's see what he makes of this. He's remounted. He'll try and prove it, I'm sure. Oh, and he's gone again. The focus is really well. It's shape. It's about conditioning, I think.
He really needs to do his dismount. Get through the routine.
Well, he made 11 in qualifying. He's not going to do that here. He's going to be underneath it. So, Vernayev, it can go wrong even if you're amongst the best in the world. Here's the wind-up, and he'll be so relieved for feet to hit Mother Earth. A giant pace, and that he will want to forget.
I mean, that's really unfortunate, because he was in with a real chance. You know, he was up there with the best. And
14.533 for Max. Whitlock for Great Britain. Ujimura still out in front, and the gap is increasing. It's a mark and a half now. Sam Mikulak has come up into second from third. Kato still in third. Max and Daniel, 5 and 6. Very nicely done indeed by them. David Baliaski drops down to 12th. Fabian Hambuchen comes to his best apparatus. He's been European champion.
Fabulous swing. Just watch this. He winds up, full twisting, somersault over the bar. In the tuck position as well. Doesn't interrupt the swing at all. Lovely straight catch-ev over. The 1.5 turns into the front somersault with full turn. Such real big difficulty, so exciting. Lovely control and style, legs locked together, not a flicker. Swinging forwards, backwards, he's shown us all types of somersaults over the bar, now away from the bar, two twists, two straight somersaults, that was magic.
Do never put your mortgage on this man not producing a great high bar. Fabulous performance. He can still get up there into the top six, certainly. This was amazing.
Oh, I was on the edge of my seat. That was a fantastic high bar routine, full of energy, daring somersaults, releasing catches. It was brilliant. Oh, I'm all excited now.
Good wind-up. Just the little hop of Hambuchen, under pressure, produces what he needed.
He is so full of confidence on the high bar. It's such a daring routine, but he never holds back, does he?
Great stuff. Chimura chalking the bars, and he is so focused. Privileged I was to watch him training for a whole week, and he had no hint that he was going to come up with this quality. He knew he was there in the background, but he saves it. He just understands how to bring it out in the big occasion. Boy, oh boy, he's doing that. A mark and a half clear with two apparatus to go. For Chimura. Parallel bars. Penultimate apparatus. Back cuts to handstand. Closes the lift doors. Very nice in the back cuts. Look at the line. Healy into extended handstand. Double with kick out. You saw the leg straight before he made contact with his arms. Peach lock. Giant, look at the rhythm in that. Suarez, nicely done. Just the first adjustment he's had in handstand. All the kickouts of it. What a combination. Tell you what. Go on, stick it. Oh, just a little hop back, but that was brilliant. Brilliant work.
I mean, I absolutely love watching him work because the skills that he does are top level stuff and he makes it look easy.
And that really is the measure of a fantastic gymnast when it looks so easy.
I mean, the sport is called artistic gymnastics.
Look at that score, 15.9-3-3. Wow. Andrei Lukovitsky on high bar, and he's impressed us with a quiet competition. Good line on parallel bars. What about his high bar, Chris?
Well, great technician, really, all round. And that was lovely. We want to see determination as well as good technique. See, he's got super straight arms in all his swinging. Very impressive. No stalling the swing at all. Moves confidently, allows the swing to keep going. Makes the shape changes as he goes. Oh, that was close, but nicely done into the back swings. Need to be very supple, and he is. He's a beautifully prepared gymnast. Quite a different routine. Changes shape up into full twisting double straight. That was very original, enjoyable work.
Very nice indeed. Were this impressed?
I mean, it's nice to see a bit of old school gymnastics in there as well. You've got the Czech Giants. A bit of variety, which is what we like. There's
the old school. That's Steinemann. Well, they're calling it Costa now, but it's Steinemann. If I was Steinemann, I'd be very upset. Very nice work.
Great work.
Yeah. There's a family out there of gymnasts. Uchimura, 15-3-3-3. Look at that line of scores. Wow. Dear, oh dear. Sergio Sasaki. So, Sergio Sasaki from Brazil. He's been impressed with his power, and I tell you what, that start impressed me with his swing. Look at this. A little bit scrabbled there, but this is a gymnast to reckon with. Funny preparation there for the Babsar, but it worked. Good into the tip out. Nicely controlled this. A little more here to lever. I do like this gymnast. Very promising round of events and a good dismount as well. 20 years old, Brazil, you could be proud of him.
Yeah, it's a busy little gymnast, isn't he? Doesn't let time stand still. controls the apparatus. Definitely not one to give up. Fights his way through everything. Which is a feature every coach loves, and you can see his coach is delighted.
So he should be, he's got a super talent there. Likovitsky, 14.8 on high bar. 73.157 after four. Calvo Marino on high bar. Now, Christine, you will be impressed by this. I hope I haven't put a curse on him, but his high bar in qualifying was super. Let's have a look.
Well, we've certainly been treated to some fantastic high bar so far. He'll have to go some. Oh, and he does. Oh, and then the stall on top of the bar. So all the marks he got, he threw away. But it's exciting stuff. Full twisting Kovacs, the somersault over the bar with full twist. A little bit round the houses on the pirouette. Squat dislocation with full turn in. Oh!
I laid the commentator's curse upon him.
You do have to say it was starting to overtake him a bit, wasn't it?
It was so impressive as well up until then. Let's blame Mitch for that one.
You want to catch at full stretch, but he just went 2 centimetres too far, didn't he? Didn't get the dowels over the bar.
Good, exciting stuff. What a world championship's all about.
Of course, he has to carry on from where he fell. You don't do the move again, generally. So it was... Oh, we've got more excitement to go. Kovacs over the bar. Actually, he times those beautifully. Another 1.5 turn. Close bar work where he brings the legs in close to the bar. Needs a big, impressive dismount. I'm sure. Oh!
That's
wow.
Gonna hurt.
And that was something we don't want to see. Mistimed his release, brought it in too close to the bar. Very unusual to see at this level.
He almost did it in qualifying, got very close, but he's going to have sore instead, Lewis.
I thought that guy's knock on the P-bars would be sore, but that's going to be aching. Bless him.
14.9 for Sasaki, and that's going to do him no harm at all. He's had a real good competition. Max Whitlock. He won't feel like laughing quite yet, Lewis.
It's only because I spend so much time with him, and we all say he's got OCD, and you can see all the little traits that he does before he goes on. You should see him when he tries to lock his door. Just check it 6 times.
I hope you don't hear this broadcast at any stage, Max, because you have to get back at Lewis.
Hey, OCD is good in gymnastics.
Yeah.
If you're obsessed, you get perfection.
This is nerve-shattering, this. And this is the second time this happened to him. Max Whitlock for Great Britain approaches high bar. He's had a good, steady series. He was in a top 6 position going into this rotation. Christine is gesticulating, stay calm. I'm calm, Chris. It's where the Max is. And Lewis isn't. Here we go. Max Whitlock. Operators number 5. Scott Hahn moves to the side to watch. Ooh, a little bit late from the Rebelco. That's okay. Good in the combination. That's better. Now he's settling down. Got his line under control. That's a better Rebelco. A little bit late in the Adler. Okay. Facing the right direction. Puts the shape in. Nail it, Max. That'll do. Well done. Nerves to one side.
Well done, Max. Great landing. Great finish.
Talking about being on the edge of my seat, that was a good routine. A little bit wild from the start of Rebelco, but he'll be happy with that one. Big dismount. Boom.
Rui Kato. Away.
And this gymnast has really impressed me during this competition. As with all the Japanese gymnasts, wonderfully prepared, so supple, so strong. Every skill performed beautifully. Look at that handstand, the extension. The lovely tight tuck and the double somersault. Super full pirouette, straight into another one. All these moves linked together, and that's how the difficulty builds. And really, not only is it so difficult, but the execution of it is so good. The judges have got hardly any areas to take marks off. Look at that landing, not a flicker.
The only thing that moved was the chalk dust.
It is unbelievable. The long swing double pike, the top gymnast making it look like a high bar routine. It really was beautiful. The Japanese really have taken the front lead on this.
Yes, it's their apparatus, parallel bars. Oh, and that's Heggy, I think it is. Heggy having a bit of a nightmare there.
I think
the grip is snapped.
I think he snapped his high bar guard.
Yeah.
Should always have a spare backup. That's it. He's run off to get.
And you have to remount in 30 seconds. So will he be given extra time or?
He's got 5 seconds to get back on. If he can't get back on, then.
Then that's the end of the routine,
that's the
isn't
end of
it?
His routine.
You saw it flapping around there then. Nah, they won't let him get on. Nah, they won't let him.
No, they've told him that's it.
Yeah.
I think the head judge will check with the.
Reference judges?
The officials.
Yeah.
The crowd are clapping to say, give him his chance.
Yeah.
But that is.
Well, they've cut
that's it.
That's the end of it. That's not good. I'm not happy with that.
It's
rules. Rules is rules, as they say. But Sam Mikulac, Paolo Vaz. He can swing this apparatus. Some of his techniques are a little bit old-fashioned, but he goes through. That was a lovely double. Kicked out in the Suarez. Nice combination. Love it. Talk about packing it in. Unusual technique to stall the flying back roll. Double pike. Well, that was so quick. That was a good job. That smile will be there. He's loving every minute of this.
Well, these top three gymnasts are not putting a foot wrong, are they?
I mean, when it's a big competition, that's what it comes down to.
Not a step on landing, not a hesitation. really dynamic work, quite a different style to that of the Japanese gymnasts. Very bit fast, very dynamic. Super height on that dismount.
Tell you what, he's smiling before he hits the floor.
His smile's getting bigger each apparatus as well.
It will do.
Kato, 15-3. He's gone up into second at the moment. 14.6. Fifth place for Max Whitlock. Dan Purvis for Great Britain.
Go on, Dan.
Sixth he was coming into this round. He would love to hit this one, Chris.
Very fast and well controlled in the first element. Here's the release over the bar. He makes sure of it, swings out well. Lovely 1.5 turn off the shoulder. Another squat dislocation with half turn this time. Very efficient at the pirouettes. Good body shape. Builds up, lifts up, two twists, another wonderful landing. The British lads are on fire.
Well, he landed in a bucket of cement. Quick drying it was as well.
What he lacked in difficulty actually on the high bar, that dismount was drilled to the ground. That was, he'll be happy with that. Rubalco turn in, you know, near enough in handstand.
Yes, it's good at this stage to do yourself justice. He didn't have the happiest outing in qualifying on this apparatus. I think he was 12-9, something like that, but it was down for him. There he put things right, and what a dismount. Wow. Great. Well, it's getting thrilling now. Mikulak's score, 15.2 on parallel bars. Uchimura, and the lead is getting bigger. Rui Kato, teammate, in second. Mikulak is still in there, still at the races in third place. And Buescher has come up to fourth. Dan Purvis in ninth, and Max Whitlock, of course, was in sixth. And I tell you, Sergio Sasaki has really impressed me in this competition. And if he goes 6-for-6, he goes for this. Quietly impressive. Lovely, hit the handstand. Full twist from it, no problem at all. Coleman out of the way. Very late with that Rebelka. You've got to hit it before horizontal, or you lose it. Very workmanlike. Nice and lazy in the heelie. Ginga roll. This is all nice. Winding up for the dismount. Double, nailed dismount. Yes, what a competition I've had, he says. And we agree with you, young man. You have got a future.
Well,
he fell off the podium.
I think it's cool. If you do a good routine, it's cool to just jump off the side.
Well, you can't ask for any more than six clean routines. 2 days in a row. Look, lovely difficulty, lost his legs just slightly on the full twisting somersault over the bar. But full of energy, this routine. Control to the end.
What a cracking way to finish. Six pieces tucked away under his belt. There's his teammate, Akiyama.
Might slip down there on the sheer handstand. He probably won't get that. Oh, and he's come to crops on the circle on one handle and
There isn't a lot of room on that. So, about 30 seconds to get back on. It's only going to take 10. He chooses the Magyar, stepping over the handles into the Shivado travel. He's picked up nicely into the triple Russian. High travel. Little leg split there. A little bit scrappy in the triple Russian dismount. Gets through. Just unfortunate about the 1-4.
Good duo, him and Sasaki. Promise well. His great piece of apparatus. He'd love to finish here. Let's see what he makes of it. Max Whitlock for Great Britain. Final piece.
And look at that, 3.5 twists into front somersault with full twist. He's so efficient on this twisting. 2.5, 1.5. Knows he needs maximum difficulty, but has to have control as well. 1.75, lovely rollout. There's some of his own unique work. Lovely flare there, and hop. Brings a bit of virtuosity to the whole thing. But he can control the elements as well. Two and a half twist forwards, jump full turn, little extra. Up, big triple. Well, fantastic competition, Max. He hasn't put a foot wrong.
That is a bit. That is a strong bit. It was 1.017 off a medal. This will do him no harm at all. What do you think, Lewis?
Amazing routine. I mean, he's a great twister, and he plays to that in his routine. He's got me on the edge of my seat. I'm all nervous. I don't know how you guys do this year after year. But I know he'll be happy with that routine, definitely.
Yeah, go on, Scott. Smile is there. He can start to relax. That's his bid. And what a way to finish. Sasaki finishes with a 14.866 and an 88.949. That is truly world class. And it'd be a good bid for a top five place. Looking, he's expecting a decent score. And by Jove, he got it. 15.266. Now then. Chopin Min. Chinese not had the anything like what we expected, but it's a bad experience. Nice and controlled through the Healy. Half turn, followed by a release from the Scott Tisler. Oh, one hand will do, one hand will do. He did very well to hang on. He was not going to be on the deck. Had ups and downs, on and offs in this routine, in this competition. But he's going on, undaunted. Wrestled his way through this routine. He'd be glad to hit Mother Earth, and he did with some style. But a few problems on the apparatus. He's had an up and down, isn't he?
Both the gymnasts from China have had very mixed fortunes, really, during the competition.
I tell you what, hanging on with one hand, that's when you know it comes down to determination. He wasn't coming off at all. Brilliant stuff. Well, for us anyway.
Some lovely releases actually here. You can see he just didn't get the second hand right over the bar, did he?
Thought we he actually did the uprise on one arm. That's incredible.
He had so much momentum.
Well done.
Was he saying that was all right?
Yeah,
was he saying it was that an all right sign or was that a hello sign?
He's going to say it's all right, going to be all right next time. Yeah, sort that one out, judges.
So I guess they have to credit the move. He hung on. That was the big thing. Had he let go and fall off?
Yeah, he'll get the move.
He'll get the move.
Be a big deduction for stopping in support.
It's the right attitude. Not our day, but we'll be back. How young they look. Xiaopan Lin, 13.966. He did well to get that. Fourth at the moment, but some very big guns still to come. Rio Iketo. Japan on high bar. And traditionally, this is the home of the Japanese high bar. But you have seen, of late, even Uchimura, I remember. In Tokyo, of all places, missed his high bar release. So here comes Kato. This really is for a medal. He has to hit it. Half turn. Takes a free swing to make sure of the release. Oh, and you see it spotted it. Half turn, then another half to make the Coleman. Very late on that Rebelco. But he's going to go through. He's determined. Wind up, double-double, and just a little skip forward. Well, he's gone through, six done. Now it's in the lap of the judges.
And what an impressive young man, not a foot wrong tonight. And now you can see the smile. He's been all concentration all evening. But now he's finished, he's done his job. Little bit of an edgy performance, I thought, here, Mitch. Couple of bent arm catches.
Done his job.
He fought on well.
Yes, he's certainly done his job. There's the wind-up, change of shape. Lovely technique. And a little skip forwards. So Kato is going to be definitely in the running. Very, very big performances still to come. Significant medal-winning or medal-losing performances still in the locker.
Three big names still to see.
And Whitlock has got a very nice 89.031. That'll take a little bit of beating. He has a chance. Bronze medal is not as far away as you might think. Just a little bit of that. Oh, 15.166, and he earned every tenth. Oh, look at that. He's not smiling, I wonder why. So Kato, good competition for him. he's gone into the lead without a head of Max Whitlock, but don't forget, big performances to come. And here he is, Sam Mikuluk from the USA.
And this, in qualification, was his best apparatus. All to work for now. Oh, and that was a very close. Huge difficulty, the full twist in the tuck as well. Two of the most difficult moves already. The 1.5 turn. Oh, he held that well. And lovely Kachev with the half turn, swings, just a tiny bit of a loss of form, and that was not very good. And this could be a major upset.
Oh.
He didn't come off, but that will be heavily deducted. Well, who would have thought that? He's shown every ounce of fight, full pirouette, lifts up into the dismount, the two twists, makes the finish, but that was not in the...
The smile is still there, but really, we really have now a thriller of a finish, because the game is six pieces, and he hit five and missed number six. Well, look at it, that's the way it goes, he said, that's a great attitude.
That was not in the script.
No, but the medal, surely, has gone. He was hanging on in the third. Let's see what happens. But Fabian Ambushi, he's pulled his way into fourth place, his last apparatus.
He's got some tools in the bag for this routine.
Certainly has. Take us through it a little bit, Lewis. Come on.
The 2.5, punch 1.5. He's always been a great floor worker. 1.5 twist in tuck rollout. Very fast pace, always moving.
You reel them off, Lewis, as if
they're
nothing.
1.5, punch ball. They make it look easy.
Yeah.
Into the Gogolazzi flare, into the flare spindle. Showing great flare work as well as tumbling skills. Little stutter on the wide arm handstand, but he's up there. A few deep breaths before the final tumble. Pulling back out, lands it, and you can see he's happy.
Well, that was the bid from Hambushin at an early 15.133. He's gone into second. Whitlock is hanging on in third, but look who is still to come. Mikuluk, 13.766, just faltered on the last apparatus. The smile is still there, but look at the focus on this young man's face. It's a cauldron out there, but you never know it by looking at it. There's a little look. Kato out in front with 90 plus. Ambushin second. Britain's Max Whitlock in third place.
I feel so sorry for him. It always comes down to this, him last on the high bar. Everyone watching him, nerves of steel.
He will shut this out. Now, if he comes off once, he will still win this championship. He's got that cushion. He needs a score of 13.575, I believe, or thereabouts. So he can afford to be on the ground when he doesn't want to be. But if I know Uchimura, only the best will do.
And absolutely silences the crowd. He was the top gymnast in qualification. Shows how and why, style and difficulty. Look at that handstand, straight into the full twist in Kovac. Somersaults, pirouettes. Lovely straight arms on the catch. Full of variety, full of difficulty. One more move. The double double. Great.
There it is.
He just flew out. He pulled the ripcord, floated to the ground. That is a champion's performance. An unprecedented 4 times. He's done it. He's amazing.
Unbelievable.
And Habushin, look at him coming from the shadows into the sunlight to win a medal at this stage.
I'm happy for him. I'm really happy for him. I think he was 20th after the first rotation.
He was, yep.
But what a fantastic competition. Those top 5 gymnasts without an error, really battling it out. I actually don't think I've seen a more competitive, really well contested World Championships for a long time.
I'm with you on that one, Chris. And we've seen a few between us. That, I tell you, was an exercise in it. 6 apparatus go for it. Mikuluk, well, he's still smiling. What an experience he's had. He's close. But the guys at the top, these two, between them, have 2 medals. Solid gold and shiny silver for Japan. Brilliant stuff.
And what a competition Max Whitlock's had.
Oh, yeah.
Unbelievable. Him and Daniel Purvis, great routines, all clean. Amazing.
Absolutely fantastic. And really just pushed out of a medal at the very last moment by this guy, Fabian Habushin, who's had the competition of his life.
Uchimura, confirmation if you needed it. 15.533. A colossal 91.99. My goodness me. That's unbelievable. Such a focused, pleasant young man. A true, dedicated professional. And Max Whitlock, hats off. Just a shave away from a bronze medal. And Bushin, though, what a cracker he is.
Everyone seems to be smiling. It's a fun fat championship. It's been great. What a competition it's been.
And winner of the bronze medal from Germany, Fabian Habushin.
This was proof and test of determination, ambition, and pure, raw talent. Such guts. Habushin emerged from in the doldrums of 20th after one rotation, and here he is, a popular bronze medalist. Fabian Habushin for Germany takes the bronze in the men's all round. And a sign, I think, of the future. Japan firmly stamped their mold on this World Championships. Ryui Kato takes the silver medal for Japan with a brilliant all-round performance. Flashes of brilliance mixed with consistency.
Gohei Uchimura.
A roar. Delight. Incredible. 4 times he's done this, 4 times he's shaken hands with the guys who finished behind him, and he'll climb the podium on a nice broad smile. What a popular gold medalist. Kohei Uchimura is in the history books. He's the one they all will want to beat. And until he hangs up his grips, no one's going to do that. Brilliant, brilliant. Fourth consecutive world champions. Gold goes to Kohei Uchimura, silver to his teammate Kato, and Fabian Habushin comes from behind to take a bronze medal. A real thriller.
Max, what a final to be a part of, and you've proved that you can hold your own with the best in the world.
Thank you. Yeah, that was an amazing competition. It was great to go around my teammate Dan in that group, and you know, that first experience for World Championships was amazing, and hopefully I can get that experience again.
And you looked like you had barely any nerves out there for a debut.
Yeah, that, you know, I just wanted to go out there and enjoy it as much as I can. you know, qualifications felt a little bit stressful in the fact that it was obviously qualifications. You had to do as best you can, but you know, I just wanted to go out there and enjoy it, my first Worlds, and have fun. And I'm glad to say I have.
Dan, seventh for you in a final that strong. How happy are you?
Yeah, I'm over the moon, really. It was a big aim of mine coming in to try and get in the top eight again ever since the Olympics last year. So, yeah, I mean, it was such a fantastic atmosphere, and going around with Max as well was great.
Max, a word for the world champion. I know you were starstruck the first time you ever met him. It's difficult not to be starstruck with what he's achieved tonight.
Yeah, Ichimura, man, he is unbelievable. And to be honest, it was a pleasure to watch him work on that last piece high bar and just absolutely nail his routine. So it's a pleasure to be competing against him.
Dan, two British boys up there in the top eight alongside two Japanese boys. It shows how strong the British are right now.
It does, yeah. It's fantastic. I mean, especially after the Olympics, it's always hard, everyone picking themselves up. But yeah, two British lads coming into the final is fantastic.
And very quickly, Max, how does this set you up for the Pommel Horse final on Saturday afternoon?
To be honest, I'm just looking forward to it now. You know, I'm really happy with what I've done here, and hopefully I can show a good pommel routine. I had a quick practice here in the all-round final. I tried my big routine, so hopefully I can try it again.
Well done today, both of you.
Thank you.
Well, a remarkable performance to have two British gymnasts there in the top eight. And I think there's just a feeling of, you know, the joy of being here when Uchimura did what he did and made history. And you said it there, Lewis, in commentary. There's just everybody's had such a great time. The story of that final with Hamboushan coming back from where he did.
I mean, it was so exciting, and to commentate on that competition was brilliant.
Yeah.
Yeah, even people that made mistakes were smiling at the end, and it was just it was a feel-good competition, and I think everyone really enjoyed it.
Yeah, and you've got to feel, you know, for Max to finish fourth, it's kind of the worst place to be. But for it being his very first go out there, I mean, it was just a remarkable way that he just kept his composure, Beth.
Yeah, I mean, it's always the hardest place to finish fourth. You're so close, yeah. But you yet so far. But, I mean, Max will be so pleased with it. We can't ask more than our British gymnasts to go out there and do their best routines, and Max, he did everything he could, and obviously he got a run out for Pommel. He tried that routine, ready for Saturday, so it was brilliant.
Yeah, and where do you think then, I mean, looking at Max's performances all the way around on the six pieces, where can he make up that? I mean, Uchimura, it's impossible to beat, almost two marks ahead, but can he get an extra mark?
I think he can. I mean, Max, you know, he's 20 years old. Once he gets a bit beefier,
he
can probably get a few more, you know, a few bits more on rings, parallel bars. You know, there's definitely room for improvement. So you can definitely squeeze some more temps out there, yeah.
Do you know, it's incredible, because I was reading about Uchimura saying that he wants to try and make it to 2020, to Tokyo. I mean, you know what it's like to compete in front of a home crowd. But, yeah. I mean, he's going to be over 30 then. Well, do you think he'll still be going all around, or he's going to have to specialise in something?
I mean, he's got the being the best gymnast in the world behind him. So maybe if they'll let him stay in the team for that reason, maybe do one or two apparatus. But we'll see.
Well, high bar could, I mean, thinking of Aliash Pagan, I mean, he was more or less an old man when he was swinging the high bar from, you know.
He was an old man.
Yeah. So there's hope there, Beth.
There is, and I mean, we all know what it's like to compete in front of a home crowd. It is such a massive pull, but me and Lewis were actually discussing this morning and kind of debating whether he'd even make it to 2016, and then obviously now 2020.
You've got to have your sights set.
But if he's not doing the all-around, like Lewis is saying, if he can maybe just take a couple of years of doing specialist pieces, then we'll see. But, I mean, he is the most amazing gymnast that we've ever had competing in the history of gymnastics. Mm-hmm.
Well, let's bring it back to our lads. Let's have a look at Pommel Horse. I know you were talking about Max got the chance to have a bit of a run-out. We'll start with Dan's routine here. So just talk us through what happened here. He's just splayed the legs here.
Yeah, I mean, he's done his Russian on the end. He's always had a little bit of trouble with that Wu travel. He likes to tend to rush it, you know, and the shoulders end up leaving the legs behind. Mm-hmm. So he just catches himself off guard, but you can see he picks up nicely.
This is the thing, he's so strong, isn't he, Dan? And he's been there before. I know we've said of his experience, and it's really stood him in good stead.
He has, and I mean, I think the thing he'll be proud of is he went through start to finish. He didn't fall.
Yeah.
But he just tends to fall back into his old ways a little bit when it comes down to that Wu travel.
Yeah.
But he did well.
And as the resident Pommel Horse expert, then what are you feeling about Max's routine? Because he had a good, I mean, he's really difficult routine, this. What is it, about 7-2?
I think it's a 7-2 that he tried here, yeah. I mean, he's got every chance. I mean, the final is very strong. I mean, there we see the Buznari, who's actually in the final with him. A little bit of a skewed spindle. So, I mean, he can get a few more attempts out of this. Mm-hmm. And a push towards the 16 score. But him, I mean, he's a real chance. I mean, you've got him, the Chinese guy, Prishan, the Australian. So it's going to be a very close final.
And it is. And there's no Christian Berkey. I mean, this is the upset, really, isn't it?
There is no
you
Christian
Berkey. You must be absolutely gutted.
I've got my leotard on underneath. I'm going to rip my top off like Superman.
Yeah. I mean, because it was... I mean, let's just quickly talk about the Olympics, because you did get the same score. It's just it was different because your difficulty didn't match his difficulty. He beat you on execution, and in gymnastics
all
they
silly.
Always go on execution. But I mean, let's have a quick look at his qualification routine. This is where it all went wrong, and it's quite uncharacteristic of him.
Well, I think he tried a new routine, a different start score. He doesn't usually do this triple Russian in the middle.
Is that an easier option for him?
I don't know. I don't know what he was. He's just. I think he had a little bit of an error going into that Russian on the end.
Yeah.
And then that spindle, you know, he just went off. And we've seen with Daniel Keating, it just takes that one moment, and it can all just go wrong.
Yeah. I mean, because that's the interesting thing, really, within this Olympic cycle, isn't it? Because some gymnasts try and hang on a little bit longer to reap the benefits of the other gymnasts that may have retired. So, you know, has Berkey just hung on too long, do you think, or do you think he's still in his prime?
I mean, I still think he's got a lot to offer.
Yeah.
I mean, when he hasn't really got many Hungarians challenging his place on the pommel horse, then he can carry on going. Mm. He's going to keep getting to championships and do as well as he wants.
Okay.
So he's in a good position.
Well, unfortunately, you're not in the pommel horse final, but let's have a list of the finals that are still to come. So we've already seen, obviously, the men's all around, and then tonight... Live, we will have the women's all-around final featuring Great Britain's Rebecca Tunney and Ruby Harold. And then over the weekend, you can see Daniel Purvis and Flo. We just talked about Max Whitlock there in the pommel horse final. And then on Sunday, Christian Thomas will be vaulting. We'll keep our fingers crossed that everything goes well for him. Because, I mean, that's an all-or-nothing sport, isn't it? Straight down.
That's it.
There's no room for error at all. So let's turn our attentions then to the women's competition, and let's have a look first of all with Becky Downey, because she's made it into the bars final, and she's always been a strong contender there, hasn't she?
She
Becky?
Has.
Never really had the chance.
She's always been there or thereabouts, and it's been difficult the past couple of years. Obviously, she didn't quite make London last year. She snapped her Achilles a couple of years earlier, so it was so nice to see her back to her usual self. We see so much talent from her, and. Like the routine that she did in qualification was the best we could have asked for her. She had one small error at the low bar that was the handstand. That was the biggest deduction that you could have taken.
Yeah. And so qualifying in fourth then. She's going to go in there with an enormous amount of confidence.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I spoke to her after qualification. She was so pleased. Her main aim was to make the final, get her name back out there, because she's been around for a while and she just... It's always been there or thereabouts and not quite made it. So this time, she's so pleased just to be in that final.
And really, I mean, she's the type of gymnast that will go in there guns blazing. She won't mess about. You know what? Yeah. She's got nothing to lose.
She has got nothing to lose. She's qualified in fourth, so we'll just have to see what she's doing.
Well,
and then obviously...
Yeah, two British gymnasts in that final.
It's so nice to see. Obviously, Ruby's got the all-around final tonight, and here we can see her on beam. But she's... She's a young character, but she's got so much mental strength about her. As soon as you put her in front of a crowd, she just seems to love it.
Yeah, I mean, it's been heavily covered, hasn't it, in the press. It's obviously been difficult for Ruby growing up. She lost her mum with cancer.
She did, yeah, and she spoke quite openly about it over the past couple of weeks. And I think from a young age, she's learned to deal with it. And her dad and her sisters are out here watching
her. Yeah, they've got time off school, haven't they?
Yeah, so it was really nice. They were here for qualification, and she's just... I really hope that she does well tonight.
And another gymnast that will be competing tonight, Rebecca Tunney. She was the youngest member of Team GB. People may remember her from the Olympics. It's Twiggy. But here she is then.
She still hasn't grown much either.
But yeah, I mean, she qualified. I think she was qualified 13th, I think.
She has. I mean, she had an injury earlier in the year, so she's had to fight back to fitness. But she's back there now, and we can see her competing on the floor here. Really strong, nice landings. And... Again, she's one of these. She just loves it. As soon as she's in front of that crowd, she just loves to perform.
Well, she did come 13th in the all-around final at the Olympics. So let's have a word with the girls. Let's see what they were thinking ahead of tonight's competition.
The qualifications wasn't my best day. I got through the bars, which is one of my main aims for the competition, and I did a really good vault and floor. Obviously, I had the mistake on beam, but I can show that I can still make it and still get the scores, like the high score that I need with the mistake. So... I just want to go out on on final and hopefully hit all my routines and show them what actually I can do.
Well, qualifying is the most stressful thing to do. So now for me, I just want to enjoy it. Like, I can relax a bit. I know my routines. I've done it once, I can do it again. So just go out and enjoy it.
Does it help you that there are two Brits in there and that you'll have Ruby alongside?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we're always cheering each other along through the crowds anyway. And just to have her at the side of me is going to be great, and we can cheer each other on. And being in the crowds, it's a bit difficult because you can't really hear them. But whereas whether I'm down on the arena with you, it's great because we can always hear them and they're always getting us through our routines.
And you can see coverage of the women's all-around competition tonight on BBC Three, live from 7 o'clock. You can also join us online, or you can watch us via the red button as well. So there's just over, 4 hours to go. What will the girls be doing?
They'll probably be back at the hotel. Getting ready, and then you have a couple of hours warm-up. We've got quite a long time in that back gym, so yeah. They'll just be, do you know what, they're probably just chilling out, trying not to think about it at all.
Now, there's no Gabby Douglas or Jordan Weber in this all-around competition, so Olympic champion isn't here. All-around champion isn't here from the world either. So what are your predictions? Because there's a new kid on the block.
There is. Simone from America, she's unbelievable. She's got the most amazing routines, clean and tidy. She's a powerhouse. Her floor routine is insane. Everyone stops to watch her as soon as she stands onto that floor.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, she's just so great. All right, she's looking for medals. I mean, she's qualified for every single final here.
Yeah, she's qualified for every final, so she'll be hoping to medal, I think, on nearly all of them. And that's the thing with the Americans, you don't tend to see them for more than one cycle, whereas on the British team, we try to keep them for more than one cycle.
So the world will probably be talking about Simone Biles from,
they will be, yeah,
from now on. Maybe
she's the one to beat at this competition tonight, and the pressure's on her. It's hers to lose.
The Uchimura, then, of women's gymnastics, Lewis.
She's got another four world titles to get, yeah.
I think she could well do it. Now, just a word on this arena behind us. You can see some gymnasts have just come in, just warming up for various presentations and what have you. White, good or bad?
Do you know what, when the gymnasts are probably down there, they can't notice it, but yeah, it is quite...
I find white is quite disorientating. Lewis, I don't know about you, on a white floor.
It's retro-reflective, isn't it? It's spreading light around the arena.
Yeah.
I think it's good. I mean, as long as you can do your job, it doesn't matter.
No, that's pretty much it, really, isn't it? So, Beth, can you give us the top two or even the top three for tonight?
I think the Americans will be hoping for 1-2.
Because they've got, they had more gymnasts, obviously, in the top 24
They
as well,
did. They had Michaela qualified, but obviously you're only allowed two per nation.
We will find out in about 4 hours' time. Hope you can join us. Bye for now.